Hey folks, so today I want to show you this super cool new sample that we have been working on. It's a sample that allows you to do some really nice stuff with RAG using CrewAI, the Docker Model Runner, and our super neat features that allow you to automatically provision managed LLMs in your cloud of choice. I know that's a lot, but we're going to dive right into it and you'll see why it's super cool. Okay, so first thing I want to do is just give you a little demo of what this is. Like, how does this work? So I'm going to go to the Defang documentation and I'm going to get some information about what Defang is. Cool. So now I'm going to come back to my little demo app here. I'm going to paste this. You can see we get some real-time updates on what's going on. And here we go. And so you get all of this stuff in real time. It's working with LLMs. Here's another thing that's kind of neat. If we paste that again, you can see found semantically very similar summary. So it just returns it super fast. So that's using embeddings. It's using an LLM embeddings to find the existing summary, LLM to do the actual summarization. And we're using Redis, Postgres, and Django, and all kinds of cool stuff. We're also using this really neat framework that many of you may have heard of called CrewAI that makes it super easy to create agents, organize workflows with AI models. This particular sample is very, very simple, just a single agent instruction task, but we figured it's a really nice starting point for you to use this and build much more complicated, much more powerful, much more interesting projects. I have this little diagram here that kind of explains how it works. So someone checks out the web app, which is a page rendered by Django, and they send a request to the app. Now, the way I've set this up is with Django channels, so you get real-time updates. So that's using Django channels and Redis to do these real-time updates. We send some text to be summarized, and that gets added to a queue that a worker picks up. And we do this so that we keep our app nice and snappy. So that if we have like really complex workflows with CrewAI, where we're working with multiple LLMs, maybe there's tool calling, you're processing the text that's coming back, there's a lot of stuff happening, that can be kind of slow. So you don't want to do that in your app. So that's why we use a queue and a worker. So that worker then takes the text to be summarized and it creates an embedding. So it uses the embedding model and that allows us to do a very quick and easy search to see, hey, do we have something that is semantically similar, that has similar language, that's talking about the same stuff in the same sort of context? So we create that embedding, and then we check our database using our Django ORM, using pgvector, to see if there's anything similar. If so, we just return that summary. Otherwise, we send that text to the LLM using our CrewAI workflow. We've got an agent and a task who are just tasked to summarize. So very, very simple. You normally wouldn't need Crew to do this, but again, this is just a starting point for you to build stuff that's much more complex. So with this workflow, we just say summarize this text. The LLM returns the summarized text, which we then create an embedding for and we store in the database using pgvector. And then we return our summary to the client in real time using Django channels. So that's also using Redis. So we send that update back to the client and it immediately pops up. So that's basically the app. And you can imagine like much more complex stuff that you could do with this. Your worker could have a CrewAI flow that's checking, is it this kind of text? If so, then do this kind of summary. If it's this other kind of text, then we should be doing some extra research to bring in more context for the summary, or I don't know, stuff like that. You could be chunking up your text so that the embeddings are more granular and you can find little chunks instead of just returning a very naive summary. You could do all kinds of really cool stuff and you can stream all of this stuff back to the client from the worker in real time using Redis and Django channels. And all of that with all of the power that you get out of Django with the admin and the ORM and pgvector, which allows you to store those embeddings and query them really easily. So yeah, I think it's pretty cool and a good starting point to build all kinds of AI-driven applications. The other thing that's very cool too, though, is that you can run this all locally. If you haven't heard of the Docker Model Runner, it is a very cool new feature in Docker. I think it's just a few weeks old at this point. And what it allows you to do is specify that you want to run a model as a service in a compose file. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so here we've got our compose.yaml and compose.local.yaml, which is the convention that we use at Defang. So I'll do docker compose f compose.local.yaml up build, and it'll take a couple minutes, but eventually it'll all get up and running. Actually, it might be faster than a couple minutes. Okay, I think we're good to go. Let's head over here and we'll check out localhost 8000. Cool, learn more about Defang. And I'll just copy this. So you can see we get real-time updates. And if we try and paste this again, in principle, we should see found semantically very similar summary. And so it just spits out the same thing as last time. And all this is real time. It's using Django channels. It's using Redis. It's storing the vector embeddings in Postgres. And it's using our local LLM and embedding models, all running using Docker Compose and super easy to access. So with all of that, we've got like six services up and running, I think. Is that right? The app, the worker, the database, the Redis instance, the LLM, and the embedding endpoint. So six services. Setting all of that up in your cloud environment is a pain, but let's see how we can make it super easy. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is we can take a look at this compose file. It's essentially the same with some minor changes. So Docker model runner, so provider type model, except I'm specifying this model Anthropic Claude Haiku, and I'm using embedding model Amazon Titan embed text. So locally we were using AI Gemma, AI MX BAI embed large, so that's Mixpread. And these are great. You can find them on the Docker Hub, easy to run locally, but we want something a little bit more performant in the cloud. So in this case, I'm going to show you how we can deploy to the Defang playground environment where these models are available. I'm going to show you how to do this on BYOC as well, and I'm going to do that with an AWS account. So that's one of the reasons I've got these two specific models, because they're available through Amazon Bedrock. So one of the things you'll notice is we've got this xDefang LLM, xDefang LLM. Of course, this is an embedding model, but this is the flag that we use for the sort of LLM workflows. One of the things that we do is we match the way Docker Compose works. And when you use the Docker model runner with Docker Compose, you specify depends on, and then LLM or embedding, any of these services that use provider type model. And what happens is Docker will automatically give you an LLM URL like this, an LLM model. So if you have this LLM service, it'll give you the URL that points to this service using an OpenAI compatible endpoint, and it'll give you the name of the model. And it'll do the same with this embedding one. So you'll see we also have embedding URL and embedding model, and we make that completely compatible with Defang. So when you deploy with Defang, same thing. This worker service will automatically get those values and we'll be able to communicate with our LLM model and our embedding model super easily using the OpenAI SDK. So let's go ahead and dive into this a little bit. I want to show you one thing first before we deploy, which is Defang config ls. So you'll see I've got Django secret key, Postgres password, and SSL mode configured. So these are things that run differently locally in playground and production. So they're useful to have as configuration values that you can set per environment. Locally, we just override things in our compose file. And then in the Defang playground, we use this Defang config, and same with BYOC. So we can change these values. So I set a different secret key for each, different Postgres password for each, and the SSL mode is a little bit different in Defang Playground than it is in BYOC, just because in Playground, it just runs as a normal container, whereas in BYOC, we've got this flag, xDefang Postgres, which will give us a real RDS database with backups and all kinds of additional features that we get from Amazon, or if you're deploying to GCP or another provider that you'll get from them. You can also see here that we're using pgvector as our Postgres image. That's because we want to store our embeddings and be able to do that semantic search. So specifically SSL mode, when I'm just connecting to a Postgres container, this is the container, and I don't have SSL configured for it. So I set SSL mode to disabled. But when we're running a Postgres instance managed by AWS or GCP, then we will want to use SSL. So we set that SSL mode to required. You'll notice that we also have xDefang Redis, which will also provide a managed Redis instance in our BYOC targets. So now that we've gotten all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and deploy. So now I'm going to run defang compose up. You'll see it's packaging up our files, sending them up to defang's playground, and it's going to start building and updating our services. So if you go to the defang portal at portal.defang.io, in here, you can see all of these things are in progress. That means they're redeploying. Okay, so after a few minutes, we see everything is built and good to go. And we can head over to our app, click on that, and we can do the same thing. Head over to the docs, learn more about defang. I'll just copy everything here and paste it in, and there we go. Somewhat better quality here. I love it. I feel like that's a pretty good summary of that page. And if we do it again, there we go. Found semantically very similar summary, and we got a summary. So you see that the first time, I guess the summary that we got the embedding for, this is a flaw in the application that I wrote, which is that we do an embedding of the summary and not of the original text. That's just because I kept this sample very simple. Cool, so this is running on defang's infrastructure, and you can check it out here on the portal. And you can see here our six services. So that's a very nice and easy way to build an LLM-driven, embedding-driven RAG application that you can deploy for free to defang to test things out, get a sense of how it is to build with defang. You can see that these deployments on our playground do get deactivated after a week. So let's give BYOC a shot. Okay, so we ran things locally, then we moved to the defang playground where we can run stuff for free in the cloud, and now we want to run stuff in our own infrastructure for our production use case, so let's give it a shot. We don't have to change anything, we just run the same compose file. So I've configured my AWS credentials, so if I do AWS STS get caller identity, you can see that I am logged in. The only other thing you need to do is set defang provider equals AWS or GCP, depending on what you're doing, where you're deploying. And now I can do defang compose up and that'll get going. So this is my AWS account where this stuff is running. And I'm just gonna show you what's happening here. If I filter by CD, you'll see we've got this cluster and I've got this task that's about to run. And that is the thing, that is a task that is going to take care of provisioning my infrastructure. Keep in mind that AWS also has to provision an RDS instance, an ElastiCache instance, or the equivalents in GCP. And sometimes that can take 5, 10, 15 minutes. In this case, I already have it deployed, so it should be a lot faster. One thing that I want to show you is that when we deploy a service with the xDefang LLM flag set to true, what happens is we provision this OpenAI access gateway, which allows you to translate your OpenAI SDK calls into calls that are compatible with your cloud provider. All right, it seems like everything has deployed. Eventually our CLI will disconnect and give us a little bit of information about how to access our services. Okay, excellent. So you can see here some information about our services. So if I head back here, we can do the same thing as with the others. Learn more about defang. Here we go. Ah, yes, I'd already run this before, so it already found a semantically similar summary. Okay, so as you can see, defang makes it really easy to deploy this pretty complicated, but really nice setup to work with Django, to work with real-time stuff, to stream messages live from your worker environment back to the browser, to work with workers and with LLMs, and embeddings, vector databases, all of this stuff, all the things you need to build something really useful with LLMs. LLMs on their own are neat. You can do a lot of cool stuff, but you mix that with something like a vector database, like pgvector in Postgres, and with an embedding model, and now you can do a lot more, and you can do things that bring language into different aspects of your application, combined with Django and its ORM, and you immediately have the Django admin to manage your data. You have auth, you have all of these things to build a modern AI app. And when you mash all of that stuff together with CrewAI to build workflows and agents, I think the possibilities are really quite stunning. So I hope you found this video really interesting. I hope you found it cool what we deployed, what you can deploy with it. And honestly, I'm just really excited to see what you all build. If you want more tutorials, if you want more templates, samples, stuff to get you started with Defang, just let me know in the comments and I will build them for you. I really think this stuff is very exciting, especially now that we have the Docker Model Runner and we have compatibility with that and our OpenAI Access Gateway. I think it makes it so much easier to build really powerful AI-driven applications, and it's a lot faster to get up and running than if you had to write all of this infrastructure code yourself, or if you were trying to wrangle multiple SaaS services and getting API keys from 12 different places just to try and get a simple RAG application up and running. So give it a shot, let me know, and I will see you in the next one. Happy building, folks. See ya.